Hello there and welcome back to Let's Play Hand of Fate. I am the RNGenius, but you may call me Eric, and in the last episode we had a lot of tough encounters in the dungeon of the Queen of Scales. We went through a lot of tough encounters and we pulled through most of them, but in the end we got whittled down and I made some major mistakes. Not in terms of combat, my performance was very, very good there. I'm proud of myself in that regard, but you know, I had time heals, the artifact that lets you recover to the health point that you entered the combat with, and well, I have not used it once, and I died, and I had 90 health going in there, and I haven't used it once. Do you see what's wrong with that? One of the most effective items is in items in the game, and I didn't use it. I could have healed for 300, I could have had 300 health to work with. But nope, I chose the hard way because I am the biggest moron. Well,
how empty my cabinet.
Let's hope we are gonna have the easy way this time. The easy way meaning I use my artifacts. That would be nice. Let's try this again.
And deadly.
No recommended encounter deck, and I'll take Twilight Ritual. Come on, give me a good challenge here. And by good challenge, a free victory. That's what I mean. Just a little bit of a free victory, you know? Cursed luck. Well, on normal mode, you gain an item, and in this mode, you just gain a curse.
Your currency is spent. Your memories tattered and torn. Formed into mere cards for us to play.
The Lonely Bard, Demon Trader, is just gonna give me a pain card. Stranger in the Shadows, Golem Hunting Party. All in all, not exactly, you know, what I'd like. So, we're gonna go. Exit Portal. That's a first. To continue, you must enter a portal. You have discovered the exit to this area. Enter the portal. You embark upon the next leg of your adventure. That's a really cool way to go about things. There's a shop. Thank you.
Once many came to play the game.
Boy. Wow. So metal ore loan. Ambertown hero.
The weak. Some come here near.
The metal ore's tempting. Just go and get it, Eric.
Any other issue than the thing on their mind today? Is that what you're doing now?
Yeah, I want the metallic ore. I know that's a lot of food spent, I know, but I really want to get rid of the Holy Forge encounter. Not happening right now, sorry. That shop could be the one with a 10 food deal, though. As you traverse, I take the ore, I know. Okay, give me the food. I want the food right now. 10 food deal, I'll give you 30 gold. I'll happily give you 30 gold. Nice! Awesome! What would you have had? Mithril? Oh man, Disciple's Ring? Oh man. Inferno Potion. Oh. Have never used that. I don't know how that operates. Innocence. Okay. Mithril's really, really good. There is no ifs and buts about it. Heavy armor and no penalty. Best thing ever. I wish I could pick that. It's just a way to basically artificially increase your health. Without increasing your health, by the way. Alright, let's get going. Sea voyage.
Nothing more pleasing than the smell of salt water and the rush of wind.
To you, maybe. Your journey will take you across the sea. You have discovered the exit to this area. Aboard the ship, you embark upon the next leg of your adventure.
This is where it ends.
Is it, though?
This is where the conclusion
Devil's is. Choice.
As much as any game can truly
end. The cloaked devil appears in your path. I'm here to test your strength, so-called hero. Choose your foe. rather not, man. I'd rather not.
You're no mighty hero. I'll let you live with your choice. Oh, God.
What kind of map is this? What is this? God, I can't see anything. I'm moving too fast. Haven't heard me say that ever. Oh my God, camera. No, no, work with me, not against me. Please, I need you to work with me here. How many projectiles do you intend to throw, by the way? 15 million? 10,000? Well, do what you can, man. Have your equipment. You know, I wonder how he's able to carry this many projectiles, by the way, on his damn small body. Ow, no, don't dodge right in that. Ow. Oh, that only took... Oh, my God. I'm glad that didn't do a lot of damage. How much health did I go in here with? 80... Oh, great. That's death.
You die alone.
God, I'm suffering from motion sickness right now because of that fight.
Death comes for us all, though not, of course, for me.
Okay. I have to make a new statement. I thought traps in an encounter were the worst thing possible. Because you can't move around freely if there's traps around that you always dodge into. I'm gonna I don't know what, retract that statement? Is that the word? I don't know the word for it. I'm gonna take that back though. The worst thing is when the camera jiggles around like crazy so you don't see a singular thing and you move too fast to be able to grasp anything. Also, there was like no movement room? That guy going ravaging on his combo? I don't think that, you know, there's a good way to dodge that if he just, well... My point being, that was shit. That was not great.
What is left will suffice to deal with you.
Ugh. I am gonna play Endless Mode.
You want to play on hard mode? Done.
That's exactly the same deep, but like, you know, things that... Dark Dwellers!
This thing I have created. I can hardly bear the sight of it now. I've worked my way through its many convolutions so many times.
Run the Devil's Carnival. One day, just as dusk gathers, you reach a large country town hosting a traveling circus. Strange sights and stranger smells confront you as you begin to wander between tents and stalls that were once brightly colored but now are faded and stained with dust. Peasants and nobles alike wander the streets and alleys past wonders and amazements, seeming almost dazed. There is something about the place that dulls your sense, and for a while you forget your quest. Forget even the path that brought you to this place. Continue. Sensing a hidden malice about the place, you turn and try to find your way back out of town. You somehow lose your way up and end up heading further into the crowds. The mysteries of the carnival await you.
A choice. Select your desire.
Its chill wind causes the lamps to flicker, and for a moment the townsfolk pause. Then the music begins again, and the merrymaking resumes. A gentleman with a large top hat and a pointed mustache waving what appears to be a wand invites you to join him on the stage. He gestures for you to get into a box that leaves your head and feet exposed. After apparently being sawn in half, you discover that you are in fact in one piece. You leave the stage to the applause of the gathered crowd, only to discover some of your equipment missing. Angrily, you turn back, but the stage is empty. You lose a random piece of equipment. Ring of Hindsight? Sometime later you find yourself standing at the edge of a forest, the sounds of the crowds behind you. Day's just dawning, but which day? Looking back, you see the ruined buildings of a country town long ago for abandoned. What did I lose? Ah, the good ring. Killing streak. Tavern wager, ratman hunting, dark dweller, and Mr. Lionel. I'm gonna go. No good gain on this map. The next step of your journey takes you from a cave out to the feet of an imposing forest. You have discovered the exit to this area. Exit the cave. You take stock of your provisions and go to continue your journey. You feel a chill in your soul as you sense the powers of darkness growing ever stronger. Well, those aren't bad. You embark upon the next leg of your adventure. Endless, a trap lurking in the shadows. Lose 30% max health? What? Why?
This can only end one way, you know.
Why? Devil's choice. Great, give me max health, please. The cloaked devil appears in your path. I'm here to test your might, so-called hero. Choose your foe. Well, that ended well last time. I'm no mighty hero. What am I going to face? This one. Since that's whom you wish to fight, I think today I shall make you fight the others instead. Just for fun. I think I can take care of Four of Dust. If not, I don't deserve being here. What? What is this arena? There's traps, there's traps, there's traps. Excuse me? Am I fighting in a trap room? What? That looks real cool, but thing is, I don't think real cool is the way to go. Most of the time. I wish they got hit by... Oh, why am I not targeting the one on the... No, I can't go over there. There's too many traps. Hi, have that back. I don't target the enemies I want to target. That's the worst. Game. Game. Can you please come back to... Thank you. Okay. That was a bad encounter. Against four bandits, I shouldn't have taken 10 damage. I really have no excuse. Excellent, the devil cries. You've passed my cunning test. Have some treasure. Perhaps next time our paths cross, I will kill you myself. Three food, nice. One equipment.
I'm sure you're grateful for that.
Plunderer's ring. With every gain card, the player receives plus one gold and plus two health. Five max health, thanks. One gold and two health. Cool, you're right. Plunderer's ring is nice. Devil's wager. Okay. A devil appears in a puff of smoke and fixes its evil gaze upon you. Greetings, mortal. Draw one monster card. If you can defeat my minions without taking a scratch, I'll reward you with gold and magical trinkets. Sure. Excellent, the devil cries with glee. It points at you with a crooked finger, saying, let's see you prove it. You said you could do it without a scratch, but I'll be generous and leave you a little more than that, although you're not going to survive a hit at that point. Okay, let's see how far I've come. Two of clubs, I should be able to take care of that. Oh, there's a trap right there. How about I don't move? You just throw stuff, okay? You know, you just throw stuff. That, I survived that? Wow! Incredible! I wanted to bash there for some bizarre reason. Does that count as not taking a hit? I bashed him into a trap. Look at you. Look at you. There's a trap right behind you. Be careful. Careful. I'd rather not do that. Oh. There's a trap right behind you. Be careful. Be careful, though. There's a trap. There's a trap. Careful. Oh, look at you. I wouldn't have been able to take that many arrows, just to, you know, remind you.
You're not dead. That is unexpected. The devil waves his hand, partially healing you.
Wow.
It then disappears, leaving behind some loot. One game card? Harsh, dude. Harsh, man.
Golem hunting party? Oh, sure.
Defeat this challenge 3 times in one session to remove it from your deck.
Well, that's what I want to do. That's why I'm playing Endless Mode, kinda. On a moonlit night, you see a group of golems on their way to attack another human settlement. The dealer draws you one monster card.
What? What? Two? What? Oh God! Will they just crumble because I'm so menacing and powerful? Like last time? Two of lava golems though! Like one isn't tough enough? Wow!
Your path leads toward them, but they have not spotted you.
No! Avoid them! Holy shit!
You give the creatures a wide berth and continue on your journey.
Well, tough luck, village, man.
Battle at Brooktop. Are you giving me all the encounters I got in this deck? Because it really seems like it.
Light draws you to a nearby hilltop where you see a warlock disappear in a cloud of sulfur, leaving behind his summoned minions.
One monster card? Since when is this so tame?
Attack. You ready yourself for combat.
I can't see the traps, but they're there.
Why are you targeting that one?
I don't understand that sometimes.
For being so finicky, this combat really requires a large amount of skill.
Nice.
There's an achievement for killing, I think, 5 enemies with traps in one run. That's why I bashed that one guy into a trap. After the battle, you search the bodies for loot. The dealer draws you 2 gain cards.
Ooh.
What? Choose to put these cards on top or bottom of the deck. A is bottom, B is top. Ringer Survival, Fool's Gold is in there, Fleet Cuffs, well, bottom.
Gain 15 health? Fair enough. It's not enough, though. Okay.
Sea voyage. I'm running out of food. Your journey will take you across the sea. You have discovered the exit to this area. Board the ship. You take stock of your provisions and go to continue your journey. You feel a chill in your soul as you sense the powers of darkness growing ever stronger.
Are you going to take away 30 max health again?
No. No, that was not as bad. Hello, traveling jeweler.
I have made my wager. I'll also make my deal. You have questions and I will provide answers. After all, that is why you came here, is it?
Who knows? I don't know why I came here. Endless mode is definitely a good way to practice your combat ability.
The lovers!
Hello, don't you have rings? Hopefully not a ring of survival because I put that to the bottom of the deck.
In the town of Stigal, you meet a man who is serenading a young lady at her window. At your approach, he stops and turns to speak to you.
My love and I wish to marry and leave this town and not drink myself to death, but her father has forbidden it. He is the master of the guild, a powerful figure in Stigal, with many armed men at his command. I saw you fighting in the arenas. Please, will you help us to escape the town that we might live together in happiness?
Oh, do you even lift? Because I don't even think you can lift your damn ukulele. You better give me something. After sharing a look with his betrothed, the young man thinks long and hard before reaching a decision.
We have nothing of value to offer but our wedding rings. If they must be sacrificed for our love, then so be it.
Gimme, gimme, gimme. Healer's ring. Whenever the player receives healing, they also gain +1 gold. No benefit if they were already fully healed. He gives you a second magical ring, saying,
this ring belonged to my mother.
Disciple's ring. Interesting. The player receives 5% less damage per blessing and 5% more damage per curse. Hours later, you return to fight the young couple hiding in the shadows. Gesturing to them to be silent, you lead the way through the town. I think failure is one monster and huge failure is two monster cards.
We'll find out.
Yeah, you don't get far before stumbling into a group of armed guards.
It's my father's men, the young...
It's my father's men, the young lady exclaims, fleeing. Her lover follows her, leaving you to deal with the guards. To a dust, and to a dust. Wow, impressive work. Why is he hiring bandits to do his dirty work? I wonder. What's this map? I know what map this is. The one without traps. I wonder why I didn't get hit there.
I wish you didn't throw stuff at me!
It's not about what I wish, though. It's not about what I wish. Wish you didn't throw stuff at me. You're gonna get that back, buddy. For hacking an empty air, I just received a huge drawback in losing my combo. Well, then again, I don't have my Ring of Killing Streak anymore, so that's okay. I like how the rain is looking like little meteor strikes. Like tiny meteor strikes. Looking cool. After the battle, there is no sign of the young lovers, who quickly leave the scene as more armed men approach from all directions. How do you leave the scene if they approach from all directions? We are never going to find out. Traveling Jeweler. Give me money? Or no, don't give me money. Give me food. In a shady grove off the beaten trail, you find a traveling merchant looking to trade with wandering adventurers. Jewelers specialize in selling artifacts and rings, such as an exclusive market demands high prices. Approach.
Greetings, wise traveler. I have much to offer you.
I bet. Give me. Democles, Consuming Shame, Golden Ring of Pain, Ring of Enlightenment. Huh. Disciple's Ring is worth 14. That is pretty good. Ring of Hindsight is something I like. Merchant's Ring I don't care about. What food deal do you have? Free food. Well, not ideal, but I'll pick up a little bit of food. Oh, hopefully I don't meet this damn lonely bard again. Desert of the Damned.
It's been a long time since I have seen the serpent, Mark.
Oh, man.
Win this and claim my token.
You find a casket buried in the sands. As you reach for it, a voice calls out.
Stranger, stay your hand. That casket bears the cursed serpent's mark.
Oh, open it. That worked out last time.
Ew.
You cautiously break open the seal, releasing a burst of stale, dusty air. There's nothing inside. Well, at least I didn't get cursed. Last time I touched a treasure, you know what happened. Goblins! One night you awaken to find your belongings being rifled through by goblins. As soon as they notice you stirring, they run away. They've stolen some of your food and gold. Three of goblins. As you rise to your feet to retrieve your belongings, you realize that it's not only goblins stirring in this cave. The dealer draws you one monster card, but he didn't. That is bugged. Oh no, they took away one gold. Did they though? Incredible. I have my fine blade left. Bad manners, people. Bad manners. How about I beat you up a bit? Yeah, you better turn around, because I'm gonna slay you. How is it that I gained more gold than I went in here with? One goblin down. Goblin, golem, all the same, right? Ew. Give my shield back, sir. Do you want to hit me with my sack? Or is that you? Do you have a different desire? This round of combat was real beneficial. Nice. Give me that gold. Why don't you pick that up, man? With the goblin threat dealt with, you continue on your way. That was a nice encounter. Because there was money dropping from them left and right, and now I have more than they stole from me. That's good. In terms of food, I don't know. I don't think I started out with 13 food. Well, I don't know. I know I bought food 3 times. No clue. Cave mouth. The next step of your journey takes you from a cave out to the feet of an imposing forest. You've discovered the exit to this area. Exit the cave. You take stock of your provisions and go to continue your journey. You feel a chill in your soul as you sense the powers of darkness growing ever stronger. Jack and Dust is in there now. You embark upon the next leg of your adventure. Draw one curse. Weak wrists. I don't like that one. How many curses do I currently have? Cursed luck, weak wrists. I would like to get rid of those because I've got the Disciple's Ring and that is 10 additional percent of damage I take. Field of Poppies? Not exactly so horrible right now. That makes me know that there's tracks in town. Angry Guildmaster. Okay. Good map. You wake up groggy and disoriented. That's the end. Angry Guildmaster, and then I can... No, I want the Minotaur thingy. To continue forward, I don't want to. Angry Guildmaster. Though the king is dead, as you travel the dark streets of Stigall one night, a nobleman atop a mighty steed nearly knocks you down. Steal from him. I probably should have listened to what the narrator had to say there. As you pull yourself up, you steal some supplies from the rider. The dealer draws you 2 gain cards. Gain 5 food? Great! Gain 1 food? Well, it's something. Tracks in town! How long has that card been in my deck for, I wonder? You're traveling through a quiet hamlet. At first, its rural aspect appears quaintly serene, but as you near the central square, you realize that the lack of activity is due to disaster. A scene of great destruction reveals itself, and you wonder what army or force of nature besieged this place. You spot one villager retrieving their belongings from a pile of rubble that used to be their home. You call out to them. Don't do this, little guy. Don't do this. The villager's head snaps round like a frightened woodland creature. Are you quite mad? Such noise will only tempt the beast to return. Can you not see that we've suffered enough? Upon further quieter inquiry, the villager tells you that a ghostly pale beast smashed through the town a few days before. It destroyed or devoured everything in its path before heading east out of town. May the gods have mercy on any who cries its path. You cannot tell whether this is a warning or a prayer.
Tracks in mud.
It is easy to follow the trail of carnage from the town into the woods. However, once there, it becomes much more difficult. Many animals and beasts travel here, and their tracks are crossed and confused.
Choose from these options.
This gigantic beast leaves tracks that are easy enough to follow. Tracks of blood. Come on, give me. Give me, I want. The smell hits you like a hammer blow, twisting your stomach into knots. You followed the tracks to a lair or den of some kind. This is where it feeds. Blood stains the broken ground where it mangles its prey. You wait in the shadows where you hope, where you both hope for and dread its return.
Not what I wanted.
Oh well, that's a waste of food. A ladder escape. To continue forwards, you must first descend down a ladder and into the unknown. Climb down. You take stuff of your provisions and get a curse. You feel a chill in your soul as you sense the powers of darkness growing ever stronger. Three mages. Endless. Lose 5 health. I can live with that. Call for the priest. I have 24 gold.
I've seen these moves repeated so many times by so many people. Of course.
Greenbarrow Forest. More and more portals are opening. I have read that out so many times. You know what's happening.
Have a difference about them. You are even different to the way you began.
Nothing. Okay, fair enough. I want to go to the priest and get rid of my curses. Twisted Canyon could be great. You see a weapon glinting in the sunlight, lying next to a skeleton at the bottom of the canyon. From the top of the canyon, you can see few handholds and its steep walls. Oh, I don't want pain cards, but I'll still try. Two pain cards. You begin to make your way down the cliff face, but soon slip and fall painfully on the rocks below. The dealer draws you 2 pain cards. Lose 5 health? I can live with that. Lose 5 health. Okay, fair enough. That's good. You retrieve the weapon from the ancient corpse. Draw 1 equipment. Uh-huh. Okay. That's interesting. That's right. It's got all the equipment cards in there. No thank you. I kind of forgot about that part. Okay, no curse seal for me then. Unfortunate. I wanted to get rid of the crippled fingers or whatever that it's called. Weak wrists. Okay, shop, you do have the 30 food deals, isn't that right? Oh, you're greeted by a kind merchant who offers you some treasure to aid you in your adventures. The dealer draws you 1 food gain card. Is it good to take, yeah, to accept an offering, then immediately sell it? Because that's what I'm going to do. Huge hammer. As you string together consecutive attacks, you do greatly increased damage. Although... Oh, that's really good. 10 food! My god! You are the best man! Well, priest, do you need a huge hammer? It's nice. In a shady grove off the beaten trail, you find a traveling merchant looking to trade with wandering adventurers. Approach the shop.
Greetings, wise traveler. I have much to offer you.
Will you take a huge hammer as well? And a sword, maybe? Okay. What about removing curses? Cursed luck is 38. Weak wrists is only 15. Cursed luck is horrible. What about selling my huge hammer? That's 17 bucks. Okay, fair enough. That is 4. Disciple is that. Okay. I will remove. Oh, what blessings are... Okay, all 75. Arcane knowledge is cheaper because it sucks. Headman's blessing doesn't do much for me because I started out with a fine blade. I'm gonna get rid of wrists because cursed luck I really can live with, although it's bad. I'm gonna wait with that until I get to the other store because that one is nice. And I think since it is a normal shop, I should get the tin food deal. In a shady grove off the beaten trail, you find a traveling merchant looking to trade with wandering adventurers. General shops offer a range of items and healing, but at prices a little higher than usual. Greetings, wise traveler. Don't I know you from somewhere? Hey, buddy. You got, like, 10 food, maybe? What do you have? Fortitude's Breath, Spirit Walk, Guildmaster's Ring. Trader's Ring. Both of these are great, and they also have good synergy. Trader's Ring is literally the one item you want when you're doing Indus mode, because you get 2 food every time you sell something. And you will sell a lot of stuff, because you get those axes and maces and normal swords that are in there, but you also get 2 food out of it every time you sell it, and you need food to survive. I'm gonna invest in the future into a long life.
Every half-decent trader has one to aid them on long journeys.
Well, great. Now I have one too. What are you trying to say here? I'm gonna buy one more food. Okay. Cave escape.
All sorts of terrible things.
A dank and foreboding cave lies between you and your goal. You have discovered the exit to this area. Enter the cave. You take stock of your provisions and go to continue your journey. You feel a chill in your soul as you sense the powers of darkness growing ever stronger.
Oot! Those are 3 specials, so okay. You embark upon the next leg of your adventure.
Traps grow deadlier. Deadly traps. Traps inflict 10% more damage.
Watching your attempt to wriggle away from bad luck. I was left these simple pieces, and from them I have built a palace of memories. A convoluted maze that few will ever reach the end of.
Nope, thanks. The vault holds no allure for you this day. Oh man, how right you are, game. Stranger in the Shadows and Surprise Portal. Stranger in the Shadows is nice. But not for the 3 food it'll cost me. I invested in the Trader's Ring. And that additional money will be nice, but that's only 10 bucks at best. Because I'm not doing the double. Or maybe I am doing the double. No, I'm not doing the double. I'm gonna go. The next step of your journey takes you from a cave out to the feet of an imposing forest. You have discovered the exit to this area. Exit the cave. You take stock of your provisions and go to continue your journey. You feel a chill in your soul as you sense the powers of darkness growing ever stronger. Endless cursed starvation. The player needs to eat twice as much food? Are you kidding me?
I'll also make my deal.
What happened to you, dude? How can you be such a glutton?
That is why I'm being here, is it not?
Cave shelter.
A challenge for you, and a token if you succeed.
You enter a cave, intending to shelter from a heavy storm, when you discover signs that it is already inhabited by monsters. Boldly enter the cave. Try to hide in the cave. Leave the cave. Or boldly enter. Why not?
You yell a challenge into the darkness and stride confidently into the cave, weapon ready. That is a great idea. You're quickly attacked by the cave's inhabitants. Hey guys, I'm gonna be here if you're looking for me. How about you come get me?
Oh, that's a really nice map, though. It's a fire lizard, too. A fire lizard, yep. Okay. Any traps? Ever since I learned how to jog faster, it's been real nice. Hi. How about you don't, you know, do that? Is there a fireball happening? No? Really did look like it. Hey, buddy. You're kind of alone here. Oh! Did he attack me? Well, he tried. Is it? No, God. I don't know what I just said there. It's okay. I'm just gonna run around because I'm way faster than them, and I might as well make good use of my speed. One is probably going to get turned around, and it's the slowest one. I pushed the wrong button. That's right. Game. I know I'm running pretty damn fast right now, and you're not a, you know, racing game, but you kind of are right now, so please behave like one and be stable. I parried that shit. Even though it didn't look like it. I'd rather not. Man, I already took 11 damage there. That was unnecessary. But oh, that's not good getting stuck on, you know, stellar tights. Ow! Fun. Okay, fair enough. I wasn't expecting you from this side. But alas, you're now defeated. I should have expected the projectile from that side, but getting stuck on that rock ended up... I thought I was... Okay. They're not significantly slower than... I wish I could just split up their resources, maybe. Like, split them into two groups, that would be beneficial. Ah, that is how that... No. Come on, lizard, this way. Yeah. Are you down? I don't have weak wrists anymore. Nice. What? Why do you live? I thought I just took care of you. Can't believe I'm down to using shield bashes against these guys. Nice finisher. Don't need to do those double shield bashes. I really do not. You search the entire cave and loot what remains you find. The dealer draws you 3 gain cards. This card's token is now yours. Draw 3, inspect, and put back. Ugh. What? Exit portal, heroes remains, cave rescue. Okay. Gain 40 gold, nice. Gain 5 food, nice. That's the first token I acquired. That's kind of poor. I'm going to heal up a bit. Just a tiny bit. And then we're going to do the cave rescue.
It seems our pirates and our bandits are cut from the same cloth.
Yeah.
Do you think it's true that men are alike wherever you find them? Or is it just that our memories fade and congeal with the cold passage of time?
I don't know. You tell me. Screams draw you to a nearby cave. Inside, you see a terrified maiden being held captive by pirates, apparently one more than last time. Oh god, since when do mages hold maidens captive? What? What happened to this universe? Three of dust and three of mages. With 41 health. Three of dust, three of maidens. Three of maidens, exactly. I wish. I'll take that back. It If it's the same map as I got last time, I'll get that. I have to take out the mages eventually. Attack the pirates. The maiden quickly hides as the pirates prepare for battle. You must fight for your life. What map is this? Is that the ship?
Oh god, that's real small! That is a really small map!
Snap. I parried that. I parried that! You do your shenanigans.
I parried that!
Okay, mash the parry button next time, because otherwise you're not gonna parry anything. Okay, we're down to three. Okay, you do the thing. How about you don't do that? Any project- Ow! Those lines didn't dissipate! No, parry- mash the parry button. Okay. Have you not learned from your past mistakes? Mash the parry button.
How-
Is that even allowed? Well, apparently I can't parry these guys anymore, so... Oh, he does the magic. I have to wait that out. Go away. Have those...
Oh, what?
Oh, I hate those projectiles, man. Can he stop? No, he can't. I parried them and dodged into them. Yeesh, I wish I wasn't so fast. Nice. Oh, it's not so nice, really. Well, I took them out, didn't I? You take the pirates as treasure. What about the maiden? Why don't I take the maiden? That would gain me 5 max health as well. That was not what I wanted. Okay, hero's remains are gonna be no fight. You pass a funeral. It's obvious from the size of the procession that the deceased was a well-loved figure. You are approached by the cleric.
This great hero fell defending our beloved town of Wondermere. His sword and shield are powerful artifacts, but must be returned to his hometown for the proper burial rites to be completed. Will you do this, traveler?
Take the hero's belongings.
Thank you. This will mean the world to his family. The town would have revolted had these artifacts not been returned. It's not far to the hero's hometown. Look for the town cleric when you get there.
Viking blade. Pain, I wish.
And hurry, it's not wise to anger the spirits of the dead by delaying their proper rites.
Heavy burden.
The black deck delivers again.
Does it though? Does it? You're sure? Heroes' return. Please give me food. It's the first time I'm begging you for food, but still. You reach Wondermere, hometown of the dead adventurer. The town cleric meets you at the gate. He appears to have been standing vigil. Return to the hero's sword.
Thank you. This blade will once again be wielded in righteous fury. Do you also have his shield?
What will you do? Keep the hero's... Oh, no. Return the hero's shield.
Truly, you have done the Almighty's work in returning this shield. Thank you. Blessed are we who, protected, can fell those who trespass against us.
Draw one blessing. Retribution. Fun.
Too powerful.
No, you didn't. God, with the curse of eating too much, it's real horrible. Yeah, I just took...
The greater the risk.
No! Oh, well, that's the end. What a horrible curse. Wow, that's an instant loss curse. It literally is an instant loss. Because you take 2 times starvation damage. Wow, that's horrible. Unbelievable. I was sitting so pretty when I entered this floor and then that happened. Incredible.
More than anything, I am proud.
Yeah, you don't have to talk to me. That is incredible. Just getting the wrong curse and then Unfortunate. Unfortunate. For exploring the cave during a heavy storm, you receive gain 3 food per blessing. I wish I didn't have that unlocked.
You are improving. Keep it up.
Am I? Previous? New. Well, kinda. Well, I found much less gold. Much more food. Even though it didn't matter. Well, that wasn't exactly what I'd call a good run, but, well, doesn't really make a difference now, does it? I hope you enjoyed it anyways, and I hope I will see you in the next episode as well. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you then. Bye-bye.